down people. I'll tell you a story, an 8-year-long story of power and pride. British Lord Vesty and Vincent Lignari were opposite men on opposite sides. Vesty was fat with money and muscle. Beef was his business, broad was his door. Vincent was lean, he spoke very little. He had no bank balance, hard dirt was his floor. From little things, big things grow. From little things, big things grow. The Ringy were working for nothing but rations. But once they had gathered the wealth of the land, daily the pressure got tighter and tighter. The Ringy decided they must make a stand.
They added luck to maintain our wetlands by mulching around the areas to keep weeds away.
They picked up their swags and started off walking at Water Creek. They sat themselves down. Now it don't sound like much, but it sure got tongues talking back at the homestead and then in the town. From little things, big things grow. From little things, big things grow. A vesty man said, I'll double your wages, 18 quid a week you'll have in your hand. Vincent said, we're not talking about wages, we're sitting right here.
Well, we use the hot house for a range of our mini plants, like dwarf beans, cauliflower.
It don't stand a chance of a cinder and snow. Vince said, if we fall, others are rising. From little things, big things grow. From little things, big things grow. Then Vincent Lignari boarded an airplane, landed in Sydney, big city of lights. And daily he went round softly speaking his story to all kinds of men from all walks of life. And Vincent sat down with big politicians. This affair, they told him, it's a matter of state. Let us sort it out while your people are hungry. Vincent said, no thanks, we know how to wait. From little things, big things grow. From little things,